Sometimes you just got to get down on, put your hands on your knees like this and really scan the ground.
Jim Bagley is searching for mushrooms.
Let's see.
Specifically, morels.
Okay, here's one that has bark. Okay, let's check this one.
He's searching for these edible mushrooms that only grow in specific parts of forested areas for 3 to 4 weeks in spring.
I'm looking for dead elm trees that might be missing the bark. I know we can find them up in this meadow, so let's go up there.
Bagley is one of tens of thousands across the country right now foraging for morels.
Ever since I was little, because up on the farm, my grandparents and aunts and uncles taught me.
It can take hours, even days, to find one. Sometimes you don't find any at all.
I hope we get lucky today.
Foragers also need to be careful they're picking the right morel. Real morels are a tasty treat, but false morels, the Geomitra species, could be a deadly mistake.
I kind of think that the Geomitra species looks like fried chicken, actually.
Experts tell me you need to pay attention to the texture, the color, and when in doubt, cut it in half.
So if you've got that nice hollow, smooth inside, you know it's a morel.
Most of the time when you're searching for morels, you're not really sticking to a designated trail, so you've got to make sure you're wearing the right clothing and the right sprays to keep you protected from tree branches, thorns, and this time of year, ticks. We were with Bagley on public Milwaukee County land for 30 minutes before he found two morels.
Oh my gosh. Okay, we got some, you guys. Woohoo!
And one more 20 minutes later.
Look at this. This is crazy. There's a morel right there.
Picking nature's food. Right out of the ground.
That's morel hunting.
In Milwaukee County, Caroline Reinwald, WISN 12 News.